Hi, good afternoon. Thank you for joining us for part two of comparing and contrasting the role of imaging in common cancers. I'm Carol Wu from MD Anderson.
I'm Chen Dong from University of Michigan.
So I feel personally very fortunate to be able to help moderate this course. I've attended many, many radiology meetings in Asia in the recent years, and I'm always very impressed by the quality and the advances of imaging in Asia. And I think this is a wonderful opportunity where we can learn from our Asian colleagues and also exchange ideas. So without further ado, I want to introduce Dr. Iinuma from Japan, National Cancer Center Hospital, and he is a representative of Japan Radiological Society. And if everybody can do me a favor and put their phone on silent mode, please.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Gen Iinuma. I'm from National Cancer Center, Tokyo, Japan. Today, I am very happy to be here to give a lecture on CT coronography in Japan. In my presentation, I would like to introduce colon cancer screening, a Japanese perspective. For prepping with barium for CT coronography, a barium suspension drink has been developed by National Cancer Center and Fushimi Pharmaceutical Company. Barium sulfate dosage is 24 grams per day after each breakfast, lunch, and dinner. This is our pre-examination meal plan. For breakfast, Chinese porridge. For lunch, curried rice. For dinner, chicken and egg over rice. And on the day, corn soup. After each meal, drink Project F, which contains 8 gram non-digestive dextrin. These are our detailed instructions. This is protocol, and this is check sheet for each examinee. And the laxative we use is mancozolol. Next, we take the data and make images from it. These images then used as virtual gross pathology, VGP, for detecting lesions. As you can see, first, we acquire data. Second, we express it with VGP. Third, we find any suspected lesions. Fourth, we view them with multi-planar reconstruction. Where is the lesion? Can you see? This is normal holes. And the red area is cancer after collapse. How about this case? Can you see the lesion? These are normal holes. And this is a lesion. But concentricity of curves is a topic that requires much further study. And this is why we look. Not only polyps, but gaps, slabs, dimples, and ideally, even unnatural stiffness. Step by step, we acquire data, express data with VGP. find and assess lesions. And then we do it all over again. Understand basic mechanism and then practice makes perfect. The slide shows future progress and problems in the development of CTC in Japan. Step first to three are what we already do perfectly. But step four through six, our present focus is for improvement. I think step four, number four, will be the key to our success. We compare all the data with pathology, and then we can train everybody. We want to clarify how more factual diagnosis will result in happier outcomes for everyone. So we want to conduct this training more. Does anyone want to send JRS a message? The slide shows comparing US and Japanese trends in medical specialization. The number of Japanese radiologists at 4,710 is just over one-eighth the number of US radiologists. Japan has only 25% of the radiologists per capita in the US. The slide shows medical personnel in Japan. In Japan, the number of radio technicians about 46,000, and many radio technicians have much experience with diagnosis in the digestive tract. And we also have fantastic teamwork. For effective diagnosis based on radiological data, radio technician first read, set up work screen, and check it both for reliability and for lesions. Physician radiologist second read, review the screen, consider each finding, and make final diagnosis. And we have frank discussion. NCC, National Cancer Center, Tokyo, Japan, started its screening program in 2004. As colorectal screening procedures, we have used barium enema and optical colonoscopy. And CTC with a multi-slice CT was introduced in 2010. And here we are working together. Radio technician, readable, lesion, discuss. Physician radiologist, review, consider, discuss, diagnose. Here is what CAD can do, both now and in the future. Effect of the CAD in CTC reading is evident. Improvement in detectability of flat lesion as well as early stage lesions is essential. Here is what we are up against. There exist the following characteristics in flat lesions and early stage lesions. Degree of isolation is relatively low in three dimensions. Degree of anisotropy is relatively high in three dimensions. We attempted that following algorithm of these challenges. The slide shows our shape recognition algorithm for CTC-CAD. From protruded type to flat type, apply a multi-stage local shape recognition on ellipsoid to flat shape, match and evaluate each shape by eliminating diameters in three dimensions. Calculate overall score by weighting parameters. We use this process for each case. First, reduce noise. Second, use high sensitivity shape algorithm to spot target. Third, apply shape recognition algorithm for flat shape. Fourth, compare with actual data set to further adjust parameters. This case is an early invasive cancer in the ascending colon. In the prone position, CAD hinted the places show in blue. In the spine position, CAD hinted the places show in green. And here is what visual colonoscopy saw. This is, here is a close-up view. In order to get CAD to help us to detect lesions more reliably, we need to give it lots of experience so that it can use that experience to arrive at the algorithm we need. And here is what we've got so far. Among protruded lesions, all were detected. The sensitivity was 100%. Among flat lesions, only the sensitivity was, the sensitivity was more than 90%. Average number of false positives were 25 per case. To reduce false positive, this new algorithm can be applied to discriminate lesions from normal structures like falls or hustlers in the colorectal lumen. And for a rookie, the guy is really, really good. The slide shows patient flow of colorectal colon cancer screening in Japan. This is an example. We screen by focal occult blood test. And about 6% positive. But 45% underwent colonoscopy. And out of these examiners, 4.1% had colon cancer. But how in the world can we wake up this 46% who ignore the results and die? We have a reliable problem because these last chance warnings are somehow not being understood as the life savers that they are. Somehow, we cannot see the writing on the wall. This is a flow chart of present screening system. Some take FOBT, some don't. Some who take FOBT have positive results, some don't. Some who have positive results get visual colonoscopy, but most cannot. At each step, people who don't take next test have an increased risk of dying from cancer of the colon. But if CTC is utilized, take more reliable FOBT will be taken by more people. The FOBT's more reliable results will merit more rational responses. Reliability through FOBT positives will seek and get CTC screening, which is not only reliable and available, but also appropriately balanced in terms of risks and benefits. Visual colonoscopy will be used both in proportion to its availability and to its advantage of simultaneous treatment. Both the risk of dying from untreatable cancer and the risk of suffering both physical and economic pain needlessly from advanced and barely treatable cancer will be reduced. The slide shows advantage of CTC. Best throughput with MDCT. High quality results even without operator's expertise. Objectivity and reproducibility will make it the standard. Digital images facilitate display, CAD, and even preparation. We are now developing new CAD algorithm in CTC for efficient detection of flat and depressed lesions. And standard sensitivity is reliable compared with FOBT. Examination is simple and uniformly safe, eliminating complications. Therefore, this is the best way to screen. The slide shows practical proposal for colorectal cancer screening. Using first screened by FOBT and second screening by CTC. Ignored very much less. And this is our proposal for colorectal cancer screening with first screening genetically and second screening by CTC. Ignoring is minimized by reliability. With CTC, some lesions are still impossible to find. Some are difficult, but some of these high probability killers can be found and stopped if we have the right techniques. The key is to clarify the remaining limitations and also the most effective settings for finding small protrusions or other irregularities by standard methods on the CRC screen. We have already developed promising technique for better diagnosis and started to conduct cohort studies to test their real effectiveness and will show effectiveness in reducing death rate from colon cancer. And both healthy life and everyone's social contribution. Then CTC will become recognized both academically and by insurance companies. Goal is worldwide acceptance and overall deaths from GI cancer. This the beige building is our center in downtown Tokyo. This the red and white Eiffel style tower is called Tokyo Tower. And you can see the top of Mount Fuji just behind tall building to the left of it. Thank you for your kind attention. And please come and see cherry trees sometime. Thank you again.
Thank you for the wonderful lecture. I'm very tempted by the Japanese prep. Sounds very appetizing, actually. So next we have, we're very fortunate to have Dr. Judy Yi, who is an expert and instrumental in development of CT colonography, to come and talk to us about colon cancer, the American perspective. Having a little bit of technical difficulty. It's giving people more time to come join us for this important session and important lecture.
Sorry.
So how many of you guys do CT colonography at your institution or in your practice? Wow, so we actually have a lot of people who are using this modality. Right.